My wife to that song. I think I'll take her out tonight. Sorry to ruin your evening. This, as everyone should know, is essentially a blues show. We are tributing two, not one, but two seminal blues artists. First of all, Robert Johnson. Although we're not necessarily tributing him directly because others have done such a good job of it, that we are going to tribute the white guitarists of the 60s from England, who actually were influenced by Robert Johnson. course, the other seminal blues artist, myself. I've told the story thousands of times about when I was a poor sharecropper in Philadelphia. Don't need to go over that ugly bit of history again.
Emphasis on the cropping!
Especially with the crazy tea party mofo. It's so frustrating. I thought I'd lived this episode in the 60s. Well, I guess you can can't take the cracker out of the man. Anyway, to support my hypothesis that I am a seminal blues artist in my own mind, we're going to play a little bit of music that will prove that.
Thank you.
thread between that obviously seminal song and the more recent past to prove that I have always and ever been in my heart a Peterson.
Yeah!
Thing, you know, it comes from all parts of the country. Some get, times get named at parts of the country. There is, of course, the Chicago blues. Particularly electrified form. Still in use to this day. Even now that we have nuclear-powered instruments. And there's, of course, you know, Mississippi blues, Delta blues, that kind of stuff. And there's this, I'm not even sure if it's part of the country anymore, Texas. Are they seceded yet, or what's going on? Are they broken up into four equally stupid states? Or three stupid ones and one smart one where Austin is? And there we have connected the Texas blues. So we're gonna do some little Texas style for you. Come over here, baby. you so much. Is this next song literally a blues song, justifiably bluesy? I'm not going to say that for sure. But it is what we call funky. Doesn't it qualify? Oh,
We'll be right back.
as I said, it might have been a little difficult, perhaps even argumentative, to call out a blues song. But what if we played it like this? See? Connect the dots, people. But we're going to do something that's so way obvious and bluesy that needs no explanation. What?
Yes.
Back up here in Chicago.
30 or so songs.
But I'm going to see what I can do about it. I'm seeing about what I can try to work for Waskegan.
But his subject matter was broad and varied and included sex with women. Some of it is very metaphoric, so it's sex with women disguised as sex with animals. For some reason, that was more acceptable. He would remark on the fads of the day, like the terraplane.
What's the terraplane?
And he would write songs about sex. What else did he write about? Masturbation. Sex and being lonesome. But he has one standout song, which actually is about, or could be interpreted as being about food. Who likes Mexican?
Yeah, she got what's in.
You gotta get some skinny ass panties. But so far, you have to bring your own.